Welcome to Fruit Logistica Media Studio. My name is Michael Schotten, and today I'm talking to Rabobank analyst Cindy van Rijsbeek.
Hello, Michael.
Hello. Cindy, you've done research on sustainability for this year's trend report. How is the industry positioned overall?
I think the overall position of the industry is very good. So in general, the whole fruit and vegetable industry is a source of healthy food and with relatively low impact on the environment if you compare to other food sectors. So for example, if you look at the carbon footprint of an apple or a banana, it's below one carbon equivalent per kilogram, for cheese it's more than 10, and for beef it's more than 50. Mm. So it really looks good.
Okay. So you know that the sustainability comprises the dimensions people, planet and profit. Where do you see the greatest need for action?
That's a difficult question. I think for all three elements there still needs to be done a lot of work. In general, the economics are not always that good, so it's quite a risky business and often low or very unstable returns. Mm. So I think that needs to be improved. Mm. And also social issues are important, especially in the sourcing countries, South America and Africa. And of course, the environmental issues need to be tackled all over the globe.
But what do you think? You mentioned the aspect that it has to be economically. How can you bring the three dimensions into balance? Is there a way to do that?
Yeah, I think on the environment, there are small steps that companies can take themselves, like using less water, try to use alternatives for chemicals, try to change packaging, reduce energy and transportation. So there's a lot of things they can do, and also reduce food waste. And often they can valorize that, so they can turn it into something useful, or just lower this and have better returns. But it's not easy. Huh? Often it takes an investment or cost, and in the long term you find the benefits, but not directly often.
Okay, yes. And on the other hand, you can see that the requirements of the retail trade are becoming higher and higher. On the other side, the prices are going down for fruits and vegetables. How can this work in the future?
That is a challenge for many players in the business. The only thing that players can do is to try to differentiate themselves, tell the story, and do whatever they can to become in a good position. But it's really not easy because there's a lot of supply of everything in the market. Yeah. So they have to find a position in the market and find good partners that are willing to pay these costs that need to be taken for sustainability.
And it's a problem, yeah?
Okay. It's a huge problem, yeah.
So you know that our business is global, but on the other side, there's an argument that only regional products are sustainable. What do you think about that?
That really surprises me, that there is a sort of negative attitude against imported products. And it's sometimes another rational discussion, I think, because what's the point if Dutch people import German cars and if German people import Dutch tomatoes? So everyone is doing what he's best in. Yeah. So I think we should not discuss this so much. But on the other hand, it can be a good marketing tool for producers, especially also smaller producers, to market their products regionally or locally. So,
okay. So thank you very much, Cindy. And thank you very much for watching us. And please follow our other videos on the different channels. Thank you.